G'day, battlers, and today we are going to be taking a look at another Ember Cup tournament recap. This time we're going to be looking at one of my locals, 678 Ghost, who won a recent Ember Cup tournament using some different movesets, we'll say, and did a really good job with it. So we'll talk about the teams in a second, but if you do want to skip straight to the battles, everything's going to be timestamped in the progress bar down below, so you can skip straight to the battles and be on your way if you'd like. But let's take a look at 678 Ghost's team. So we've got Charizard, but as I said, there are some wacky movesets going on. This is not a Blast Burn Charizard. I was ready to go on this big rant when I looked at 678 Ghost's team. I was like, okay, you know, Blast Burn Charizard, one of the best Pokemon in the meta, because with everything being so squishy in the Ember Cup, a Blast Burn threatens everything. So you can pretty much, like, you can almost get a shield from everything. Like, even Poliwrath doesn't want to take a Blast Burn from Charizard, especially when the Wing Attack fast move is doing so much damage to you. It's just sort of adding up while giving Charizard that big energy for the big damage. Ghost is not running Blast Burn though. He's got Dragon Claw, Overheat. Now, Overheat is slightly more efficient than Blast Burn. It only costs 5 more energy. You actually get to the first Overheat at the same time as you would the first Blast Burn with Wing Attack, sorry. The downside is that it does debuff your attack 2 stages. So it's a little bit of a different move. It's definitely going to take people off guard who are very confident with what their Pokemon can and can't take. I think it's actually the difference between a one-hit KO against a Hisuian Quillfish and not. I mean, the Wing Attacks do that if you're in, like, the lead matchup, but for, like, a late-game closing scenario, you've got one move to throw. They've just thrown another full-health Hisuian Quillfish. I mean, Overheat could seal the deal for you there, but I think it's going to be a surprise factor. It's going to be the biggest thing for there. Otherwise, I'm not sold purely on the numbers, Overheat being better than Blast Burn, but again, Ghost has just won a tournament using it, so we'll see how it does end up for him, and whether we may become Overheat converters ourselves. Then he's got Poliwrath, not running Dynamic Punch as I did in the last video, but he's running Ice Punch and Scald. Scald, I feel like, is your bread and butter in this meta. Ice Punch is just sort of a spammy move. It gives you a bait move. It can get you out of a lot of spots where you just need to get that little bit of advantage back. They might have swapped in just before you and you're just a little bit behind. Getting an Ice Punch bait can really help level the playing field or put you a little bit ahead, which can be huge in this meta. So it gives you a bit of a different play style, which 678 Ghost is likely to sort of go down that route. The other thing you lose by not having Dynamic Punch is that you do a little bit worse in the Poliwrath mirror, assuming that they have Dynamic Punch, which is why I like it, because Poliwrath is so common. It also does, I also kind of like using it against Hisuian Quillfish as well, but Scald kind of does the job just as good there. And then Ice Punch also just gives you really nice quick coverage against things like Gligar. But that's that. He's got Electivire as well. Not running Wild Charge. He's actually running Thunder Punch, Ice Punch. So no debuffs. He's got enough debuffs on the Charizard. But, you know, Thunder Punch and Ice Punch gives you enough coverage to sort of be a little bit of a core breaker. Do a little bit of a good job against things like the Flyers. Also giving Thunder Punch to against things like Poliwrath. So we'll see where we definitely see at least one Electivire. I basically just, like, found the movesets by scanning through the video to try and find the moveset for all the Pokemon. I haven't watched the battles. Ghost didn't give me a heads up about how it's going to go, but I know Electivire at least shows up once. So we've also got Primeape, but Primeape is not running Night Slash. Primeape is running Ice Punch and Close Combat. So big fighting nuke. I guess that's because Poliwrath doesn't have Dynamic Punch, and then also running that Ice Punch for the Gligar-ish coverage. Then we've got Gligar not running Return. We've got Night Slash and Aerial Ace here. Aerial Ace giving you a bit of that, again, more Poliwrath coverage, just because you are losing that Dynamic Punch from your own Poliwrath. So Ghost is sort of like, he's prepared to not have Dynamic Punch on his own Poliwrath. And then we've got Poliswine just lining up the back. A little bit more Ice coverage. Sort of a little bit of a bread and butter pick. It's kind of RPS-ish, but not so much against a lot of Pokemon. Like, Piliswine and Hisuian Quillfish do a lot of damage to each other. Avalanche does a lot to Quillfish. High horsepower would one-hit KO, but then Quillfish does a lot of damage with the Aqua Tail. So I guess it's not that RPS. Just some Pokemon, it can be a little bit rough. But with that said, let's jump into the battles in round one up against Adam Not Charlie, who's running Runerigus, Hisuian Quillfish, Piliswine, Charizard, Surfish, and Poliwrath with the double fighter strat. So Because there's double fighter, it could mean that Gligar's got a bit of play here. I mean, Gligar does have a bit of play here, especially because they've got Runarigus, who's going to be weak to the Night Slashes. So let's stop stalling and jump into the very first battle here. 678 Ghost taking on Adam Not Charlie. Charizard versus Quillfish. It's a little bit of an interesting matchup because you really need to land, usually the Blast Burn, but you need to land the Overheat here. If you just go straight Dragon Claw, you are going to lose. Quillfish with the Poison Jabs, already doing a lot of damage adding up with the Poison Jabs, but Aqua Tail does like a little, around half of Charizard's health. So you can sort of do the maths in your head and see that Charizard's already lost about half of its health to quick moves only. So Aqua Tail, really scary. Charizard really needs the big fire nuke, but only going for straight Dragon Claw. I guess a different play where Ghost is actually going to try and go for a bit of a farm down, get a little bit of energy on one of his Pokemon in the back, and try and sort of keep momentum up in that regard. Brings in the Poliwrath, going to try and Mudshot down here. Does get to a move. I think this is only an Aqua Tail though. It's just an Aqua Tail, so Poliwrath able to tank that really easily. And here comes the Sirfetch. Scald would really hurt there. And Ghost going for a really interesting play here. Ghost is swapping into Gligar to get an energy advantage on that as well, knowing that Adam Not Charlie would either have to stay in with Sirfetch in a not great matchup, or swap into something that would then be a little bit energy behind the Gligar. So Ghost, really big plays here, doing really nicely. And as we're going through the Night Slash here. Charizard, very squishy Pokemon, as is everything, so it would take it out. Blast burning that last shield, anyone? Blast burning Ghost last shield? No, it's actually the Dragon Claw bait. So that is Charizard, another Pokemon that has that bait ability that not a lot of Pokemon in this meta do access. But that Night Slash, going to be enough to take that out. Here comes the Sirfetch, and just going to quick swap into Poliwrath. This Scald is basically going to be enough to take this Sirfetch out, because Scald is a good move, Sirfetch is pretty squishy, and that is game one for Ghost. Game two, bit of a swap out of the lead into Electivire, just because Charizard wasn't as great there. Interesting swap out into the Charizard here, because Charizard, not a great matchup against Electivire. Because Electivire's got access to the Thunder Punch, can do a fair bit of damage, especially because Electivire has a really high attack stat, so it does do a lot of damage to that Charizard. Goes for the Blast Burn Nuke after going for Dragon Claw like all game last game, but does get the shield. Ghost calling it correctly, recognizing how important this Electivire must be if Adam Not Charlie was sort of willing to swap in their Charizard to it. If Charizard's not a great matchup against it, then they mustn't have a Pokemon, or they're just keeping it in the back. But either way, going for the Thunder Punch here now that both shields are down, and this is going to be enough to take out that Charizard. No shields left, but here comes Sirfetch'd, going for a Thunder Punch. This is sort of where Wild Charge would be nice to have, but again, Sirfetch'd is so squishy that Thunder Punch already does a fair bit of damage there. Gligar coming in can tank literally any of Sirfetch'd moves, so not too concerned here. It is the Brave Bird, so massive nuke does bring it down really low, but going to be able to get an Aerial Ace off onto this Hisuian Quillfish, and then I guess you're probably going to see a pretty a swap as soon as you can. Unfortunately, Switch Timer is not up yet, so just going to go for the Night Slash, do a little bit more chip damage rather than going down without it. I mean, you may as well, right? So down into the bit deeper yellow, and now going to be able to bring in either Pokemon here. Poliwrath is going to be able to tank any move from the Quillfish. Switch Timer still isn't up, so not able to make any sort of catch onto the low health Electivire in the back, but tanks that Wild Charge, gets the Ice Punch. Again, this is where Ice Punch really actually shines on Poliwrath. It gives you that spam ability, that really quick charge move that can get you out of these tight positions and just secure to game two for 678 Ghost. Going into game three, though, we've got a shiny Primeape. Is this team, it's all shiny except Gligar by the seams of it. Primeape swapping into the Poliwrath, catching the move from the Charizard. If it's a Blast Burn, that's huge. It is just the Dragon Claw, but still, that is really nice for 678 Ghost. You can see like the Air Slashes are adding up more damage. Wing Attacks. I keep saying Air Slashes. The Wing Attacks are adding up more damage than even the Dragon Claw did. So burns the shield there. Wants to keep this Poliwrath around and tries to go for the bait here. Can he get the shield? He does get the shield. Really nice there. Again, another benefit of the Ice Punch. Going for the Scald now that they did go for that bait with the Ice Punch. Had access to a bit more energy. Scald getting that second and final shield from the Charizard. Charizard going for the full farm down now. So Ghost is in a little bit of a tight position. Here comes Primeape though. Going to shield up the potential Blast Burn. Is just a Dragon Claw. I say just. Primeape takes a lot of damage from a Dragon Claw still. So sort of force the shield there either way. going for the Ice Punch, now bring it down into the deep red and catching the move onto Gligar. Gligar can tank either move from Charizard, can tank the Blast Burn. Wing Attack down. We see a swap out into the Surfetch in the back. It is so squishy that this Aerial Ace probably is enough to take the Gligar, take the Surfetch out, sorry. But there is not a lot left. Okay. I think this is GG's. Piliswine in the back now has a lot of energy where Primeape has none, and an Avalanche is all Adam, not Charlie, is going to need to take out 678 Ghost Primeape here, and that is GG's, but Ghost still taking out the round with a 2-1. So moving on to round two now, against Warrior J Mac, who is running the Poliwrath, Charizard, Quillfish, Runarigus, Piliswine, and Gligar. I've said this about Ember Cup, everyone knows it. It's a very tight meta in the sense that there are not a lot of different Pokemon you can use. Ghost is obviously breaking the mold a little bit by using different move sets, but it's still, you know, you're seeing very similar teams all around. This one's no different. It is running single fighter instead of the double fighter strats that we saw on Ghost's team as well as Adam Not Charlie's, but we'll see how it does play off for him going into round two with that win up his sleeve, I guess you could say. We've got the Electivire into the Piliswine. Not an awesome matchup for Electivire because you aren't doing huge amounts of damage, whereas an Avalanche from Piliswine does a lot to you. So farms up a little bit of energy and then swaps into the Poliwrath. Poliwrath going to be able to tank either move here. High horsepower does do a lot, but can tank it pretty comfortably. But here comes the Gligar. Gligar's going to be doing a lot of damage with the fast moves here. Going to be able to basically farm down, but the Ice Punch able to get it out there. And because it is so spammy, Poliwrath able to get two Ice Punches off before going down. So really forcing that Warrior J Mac to burn that first shield. Now able to bring in the Electivire, potentially just as a damage soak. Going to be able to tank whatever move this is though. Actually goes for the Aerial Ace, which is resisted. Night Slash is the better move to go for against the Electivire, I'm pretty sure. So going to go for the Ice Punch now, which does take the Gligar out. Here comes the Primeape. A little bit less energy on the Piliswine this time, but still pretty loaded. So has to burn the shield on the Primeape to keep this around. Is going to have to burn another shield if they want to go for a full farm down. Oh no, it actually just isn't. Going to have to take Piliswine all the way down. Here it comes. Oh, that was the Shadow Claw. So this is Runarigus. No Night Slash as you would regularly have on a Primeape here. So it does still get the shield. Ice Punch. Going to do about half damage. 50% of Runarigus's health. I think. Yeah, down to about half health. Not going to be able to get to another move before Runarigus can get to a Sand Tomb. Sand Tomb is a pretty low damage move though, so Primeape actually does survive there, but you know, it's not going to get to another move there and really just gives Runarigus another Shadow Claw. But here comes the second Ice Puncher on the team, throwing the Ice Punch that is going to be enough to take out Runarigus, and that is game one going to 6-7-8 Ghost. We've got the Charizard in the lead this time up against the Gligar. Do we finally see an Overheat being thrown, or would he keep the sort of keep it on the down low, keep throwing these Dragon Claws? We'll just have to wait and see. Can take a move from the Gligar, but squishy is probably a word that I'm going to throw around more than any other in the Ember Cup meta because everything is so squishy here. But here's the Overheat and boom, taking out the Gligar. Huge amount of damage. Warrior J-Mac was definitely not expecting the Overheat. Huge, huge. Is revealed now and swapping out of the Charizard so that he's no longer double attack debuffed. Going to take an Aqua Tail onto the Piliswine. But as we've seen in previous videos, Piliswine does a lot of damage with this Avalanche. So forcing that first shield out of Warrior J-Mac. I'm probably just going to let Piliswine go here, this Aqua Tail. I mean, like, if you shielded it, another Aqua Tail would be coming pretty quickly, and Piliswine doesn't have a lot of health left to stand on. So going to bring in probably Poliwrath just to get a little bit of energy here. Soak up a bit more damage from the Quillfish. Especially because Quillfish is sort of being pushed to throw the higher energy Shadow Balls here rather than the baity Aqua Tails. Charizard, you'd just be throwing Aqua Tail, be a little bit quicker and deadlier. But burning the first shield on the Shadow Ball, throwing the Ice Punch to bring it down. Really low health Quillfish, still hanging on in the back. But here comes Poliwrath, and this is where the Ice Punch Scald moveset may come to hurt Ghost. We'll see if Warrior J-Mac is running the Dynamic Punch, because if he is, it puts him in a tough spot. Catches a move onto the Charizard, maybe not a catch if J-Mac is quick enough. It is a Scald though, so going to take Charizard out, and that does put Ghost in a little bit of a better position, just wasting a bunch of Warrior J-Max energy. So now Ghost is in a little bit of a better position if that Poliwrath does have Dynamic Punch. I guess we might see here if he's packing it. It's just a Scald, doesn't mean that he is definitely Scald Ice Punch, but you know, still not a terrible spot to be in. But at this point, I think he actually may be able to take another Scald. And he does needs a charge move for the Pokemon in the back though, while also taking out this Poliwrath, while also taking out a shield. So I feel like Ghost might be in a little bit of a... Oh my gosh, by swapping into that Pokemon, that actually gave Ghost a bit more energy, and now he's actually going to be able to throw this Scald, take out the opposing Poliwrath, and win the game. I mean, would Ghost might have won that anyway, potentially, but, you know, that really... Actually, probably not. That may have actually given Ghost the win, but that's 2-0 in round two, but we've got game three to go. Electivire into the Poliwrath, brilliant lead for Ghost. Here's a swap out into the opposing Charizard. Thunder Punch again. Going to do a fair amount of damage here, and puts Ghost in a pretty happy position, seeing a Charizard, because it's like, I mean, if that's what you're swapping into Electivire, I'm not in too bad a spot. But here comes the Charizard into... here comes the Poliwrath into the Charizard. Just one Scald, all you're going to need to take this thing out. And we'll tank these moves pretty well. Just going for the straight Dragon Claw by the looks of it. I mean, you do only need either three Dragon Claws or two Dragon Claws plus the fast moves and a little bit of shield investment to take it out. But just going to let it go there. And was the Scald. Here comes Gligar, and again, Ice Punch. So spammy and fast. This is the way, like, I've seen people going, why do you need Ice Punch? This is a place where Ice Punch can be really useful. Getting the second and final shield from Warrior J-Mac now has Charizard in the 2-0 shield advantage against Gligar. So really nice spot here. Gligar does have a bit of energy though. So, okay, here comes the second charge move already. And 678 Ghost deciding does use both shields here to keep Charizard healthy and alive. Going straight for the overheat though. We saw how much damage this did to Gligar before, and it is going to do that again. One hit KO, take that thing out, and the quick swap into the Electivire to take this Poliwrath back on from the lead. Going to be doing a ton of damage here. And I mean, Poliwrath is going to do a lot of damage with either charge move, but probably a Scald might take Electivire out here. I think it does. Yeah, does take it out. And then here comes Charizard to try and take this thing down before another Scald comes through. Is able to do it. And really nice plays there from 678 Ghost getting the 3-0 against Warrior J-Mac. One of the most prolific battlers out there. Now, round three, we've got I Troll Myself A, who I also played in my previous tournament. Still running that Minun with the Malamar, Poliwrath, Alolan Marowak, Piliswine, and Hisuian Quillfish. Minun is a really interesting pick because, like, Electric is a very useful typing in that it counters Poliwrath and there's a bunch of flyers running around, but I don't know. I'm yet to be convinced of Minun's spot here, but I Troll Myself A really pushing for that Minun hype. So we'll see if we can get that hype going. Also running Malamar, which is another interesting Pokemon that's been plopped into this meta, but we'll see if we'll see what we see. And we've got a really bad lead here for Ghost with Gligar into Piliswine. So we see the mirror swap. Does mean that 678 Ghost is at the disadvantage because he's behind by a move, but we'll see how that plays out. Burning a shield on the first Avalanche, staying in, so farming up more energy on Ghost side, potentially in case of a swap, but no, just going to go for the Avalanche. We'll see if Troll goes for the back shield again. And we see the one shield apiece, but now that he's opposing Piliswine has a bit of energy, seeing the swap out into the Minun, able to take that first Avalanche pretty well. I think that Piliswine can take any move from the Minun. I could be wrong about that. Correct me if I'm wrong in the comments, but getting that second and final shield from the Minun and now swapping it into the Gligar has the flying typing, but also has the ground typing. So Electric not going to do much at all. Grass Knot is going to come through there, but is only neutral because of that flying typing still. Going to be able to take another one here. And then should be able to potentially, probably not farm down. Maybe farm down. Do see the farm down. So much energy packed into this Gligar now. Here comes the Piliswine though. This is not going to do a lot of damage here. And to be honest, neither move would have. But actually, the Aerial Ace Night Slash combo may be a bit of damage. I'm not sure if it's going to be quite enough. Yeah, it is going to be a round of the red. Gets the boost. Always comes at the most useless times. But regardless, here comes the Poliwrath. But Quillfish swapping into the Poliwrath. Plus, Ghost still has a shield and Troll does not. So Ghost is in a really, really powerful position here. Attack debuff as well going through. So really just unbeatable position at this point. Swapping in the Piliswine. Just, you know, actually going to burn the shield here. And then we'll be able to Powder Snow down. We're going to see Piliswine get taken out. So either way though, Aerial Ace going to come through, going to take, oh my gosh, does take it out. But then Pillarswine sort of comes in for the snipe anyway. I'm pretty, like, I'm not wrong here, right? Like, Poliwrath can take a high horsepower, and one mud shot's all we need. One mud shot's all we need. So really, actually, much closer than I was sort of expecting there, but I think Ghost probably could have just stayed in with Poliwrath and got a similar result. Maybe. Regardless, we've got the Coolfish up against the Primeape. Primeape ready and to throw these big old cross chops. Did I say close combat at the start? Sorry, my bad. It is cross chop. I must have just got confused with the fighting move, but it does a lot of damage to the swimming Coolfish, right? And then countering it all the way down at the shield disadvantage, but we'll see what Troll decides to bring out here. Primeape Dance. We've got the Poliwrath coming in. So cross drop doesn't do a ton of damage, but it's sort of like the dynamic punch of the Primeape in the sense that it's a fighting move that's, it doesn't really matter. Doing a lot of damage here with the counters alone, but just going to let Primeape go now. In comes the Gligar though. Gligar still really scared of the Scald, potentially trying to catch a Night Slash on the Pillarswine, but didn't work there, unfortunately, for Troll. Able to swap into the Poliwrath now, and this actually could put Ghost in a potentially advantageous position, where he's able to farm up a little bit more energy and then take the Pillarswine out, going straight for the Scald though, and actually just going for all the bubbles. So gets the shield though. Actually, yeah, there was still two shields on Troll's side. Actually, a pretty rough spot for Ghost, and really nice counting from Troll myself at his side, throwing it the perfect opportunity, forcing the shield out of Ghost, who had to shield, like, a, I don't know, 5 HP Poliwrath. Not what you want to do, but wanted to shield it for the Scald, trading the two shields, but now Poliwrath, Pillarswine, oh my gosh, able to get to the Scald before getting taken out, but the catch onto the opposing Poliwrath, going to take that out, is now going to be Gligar versus Pillarswine, which is not where Gligar wants to be in any sense of the word. We saw how much Aerialace did before, and it's not a lot, but can they get to another one? I don't think so. Avalanche does a lot of damage to the Ground Flyer. Here it comes, and yeah, down goes Gligar pretty much straight away, and Poliwrath comes in for a, you know, one mud shot, but it's GG's there on game two. And so we're going into game three with a 1-1 scenario, and we've got the Poliwrath to Poliwrath mirror. So we'll see how it does go. Ghost has the shiny advantage. Interesting swap into the Charizard. Maybe expecting the dynamic punch to be thrown, maybe just sacrificing it, maybe just expecting to use one shield there. But regardless, here's Quillfish, and Quillfish is going to be looking at an overheat in the face. Do we see the shield come up though? There is the shield, a little bit unfortunate for Ghost, because now this Swishlocked Charizard is debuffed and not doing as much damage, and it's not awesome, but Aqua Tail just going to come through here. Put Charizard out of its misery. So here comes back the Primeape. Primeape doing a lot of damage with the counter. Cross drop does a lot of damage as well, but will take a lot of damage from the Shadow Ball that was about to come through. So shielding up there, going for the cross drop. There's still a shield on Troll's side. So the question becomes, do they decide to burn it? They don't. They want to keep the shields for the back. Here's Poliwrath. Primeape is going to be able to weaken this Poliwrath down so that Ghost Poliwrath can do a little bit of a better job against it. Brings it down into the sort of mid-yellow, and a Scald is going to really, really hurt Primeape. Yeah, down it goes. And then here comes Primeape, and it is Pillarswine in the back, going for the Ice Punch bait. Ghost really just hoping that this all plays out. It is going to be close no matter what happens. Gets the shield with the Ice Punch, and so able to get to this Scald to land. Now there's no shields left. Onto the Pillarswine, does so much damage, and going to see on a farm all the way down. Pillarswine going to be able to get a high horsepower off, but we've seen before, Poliwrath is going to be able to tank it, and then have a ton of energy with this full farm down, with such low health, to barely throw the Scald, hit the Poliwrath, but it's not over yet, I don't think, because this Poliwrath is going to be able to tank that Scald, barely, but there's so little health there, and much down. Oh my gosh, what a finish. I'll be honest, I was sort of doubting myself there. I was like, wait, but Scald isn't going to take it out. He does win the tournament, and it's 1-1, so he has to win this match. Can he win this match? How does this happen? But there it is, just leaving it on the sliver of health that it's just that sliver lower than Ghost's own Poliwrath and able to mudshot all the way down there. That it's just, oh, I don't think it's how Ghost was planning the match to go. But I don't think he's going to be complaining about winning the match there. And now that does mean that he's 3-0. Going into round four. Well, technically he's 4-0 at this point, because this was a round robin tournament and he got a bye in the first round. So I guess he's now 4-0 going into round five. I'm putting that in the title now. Ghost goes 5-0, even though we're only going to see four rounds of battles. And I've already done the intro, so I can't mention that it's not that. Do you want, I've said it now. I've said it on, it's a 5-0 clickbait title. Pew, pew, pew. thanks, Round Robins. But now we've got Pirate Hassan coming in with the finals with Charizard, Poliwrath, Hisuian Coolfish, Electivire, Piliswine, and Gliscor. Almost identical team Pokemon-wise, just swapping out the Gligar with the Gliscor. But again, where Ghost is coming from is these different movesets that can play out so differently there. Did I say identical teams? He also doesn't have Primeape. He's running Hisuian Coolfish, which I sort of buried the lead with that, in that Ghost is not running Hisuian Coolfish. I mean, maybe that goes in the title as well. Sure, going in the Twitter post. I'm just unloading my mind to you as we sort of, you know, I'm just wasting your time. So I apologize for that. Let's get into round four against Pirate Hassan for the finals. And we've got Electivire into the Gliscor. Not a great lead. I guess it's not great either way. I guess Electivire has the Ice Punch. But we see that double swap Piliswine into Primeape. Now the matchup we're looking at, with Primeape in a really solid position here, farming up a ton of energy, doing a ton of damage with the counters, and now this cross drop, which would be enough to seal the deal. Getting a shield here though, and not going to get enough energy to be able to go for another cross drop first. So has to burn the shield here, and now we'll be able to counter down. But this is an Ice Punch cross chop Primeape. So even though here comes the Gliscor, which would be okay with cross chop Night Slash, it's Ice Punch. Oh my god, look at that damage. That is so huge. Almost a counter down as well. Pirate Hassan must be sitting there like, oh my gosh, this is not good. And Ghost is going, oh yeah, I know what's up. Here comes the Poliwrath though. Pirate Hassan swapping in there, Poliwrath a little bit slower, but swapping into the Electivire here, just because, again, a little bit scary when Dynamic Punch is a possibility. And just look how much damage that Thunder Punch does from these. Ember Cup is just filled with so much high attacks. That does have the Dynamic Punch, so really good information to reveal. Does mean that Ghost is a little bit scared here, but with so much health, we'll be able to tank one Dynamic Punch. Goes for the Ice Punch bait and takes it out. But, I mean, I say bait. It's not going to do, like, there's so little health on Poliwrath that it's probably all you need. Tanks the Dynamic Punch here, and even if this Ice Punch wasn't enough, I think a couple more Mud Shots would do the job. But yeah, does take it out. Here's the Gliscor in the back with one Mud Shot. You don't usually see a Mud Shot taking out a Flying type, but there we are in first game, going to 6-7-8 Ghost. Here comes game two, and we have Piliswine into the Electivire. Interesting matchup, can go either way depending on how shields and moves go. First move coming off from the Electivire though, so we'll see what it is. It is the Ice Punch. Does hurt, but Piliswine can take it pretty decently, charging up to the high horsepower and just going for the Avalanche. To be honest, you don't need high horsepower against Electivire. You can probably just go straight Avalanche because it is so, so damaging when Electivire... I'm going to say the word again, add another tally mark. Electivire is so squishy. But there's the Wild Charge. Is resisted, but does do a fair amount of damage. So I don't know how you rank that as far as like how awesome that is for you or not, but regardless, see the swap it into the Poliwrath, taking the high horsepower and then swapping into the Primeape, who is now, yeah, probably best to burn the shield and then will actually be able to counter all the way down. Ghost in such a commanding position here. Like, this is really just excellent for 6-7-8 Ghost. And we see the swap in from Pirate Hassan coming in with the Charizard. Ice Punch is doing okay amount of damage, but it's definitely Charizard's match to win here. Actually does a fair amount of damage, already down into the yellow. And going to get to a charge move here. Ghost deciding whether he's going to burn the shield. He does want to burn it because he's going to be able to get to the Ice Punch here. That would be enough to take Charizard out, or at the very least, take out Pirate Hassan's final shield. So what does he go for? Burns the shield, swaps into the Poliwrath, who again would be able to tank any move. And with the energy advantage, able to get to the quick, spammy Ice Punch that is going to be enough to take out Electivire. Electivire go down, it is just down to the Charizard in the back. And at this point, Charizard is not going to be able to do much against Ghost's team. Here's the Blast Burn, so we can at least see how much that would do, but able to survive, go for the Ice Munch here, and then he's going to take out Pirate Hassan, and also take out the Ember Cup tournament with a technically 5-0 sweep, but for the knowledge, for the learning, we're jumping into game three regardless with Primeape into that Piliswine. Really good matchup for Ghost. See the swap out into Poliwrath, so we swap out into Gligar. Sorry, we've seen the Dynamic Punch. Have we seen the other moves? It is Skull Dynamic Punch. So that is really going to hurt the Gligar and get the attack debuff as well, which is pretty unfortunate when you want to be doing as much as you can in this matchup where you're trying to get this thing out of here. And to be honest, I think that's actually swung this matchup. It's given Poliwrath the opportunity to get another charge move just based on that Skull debuff. Taking out the Gligar, but now means Charizard is going to be able to come in with an energy advantage. So not the worst spot for Ghost. Not ideal, though. Here comes Piliswine. This is where Blastburn can sometimes pay a few more dividends just because it's that little bit quicker and Piliswine can be a little bit scary, but goes for the Dragon Claw bait and catches the move onto Primeape. Ghost in his prime here, catching the Avalanche, does do a lot of damage to Primeape, but Primeape was going to be able to get to a cross drop on the Piliswine, but instead going to be getting to a cross drop on the Electivire. Not quite able to get to another charge move as well, which is pretty unfortunate when you get Thundershock down. Thundershock, not a big damaging move, and able to get a charge move off with no HP on that Electivire. Gonna go down there, but now it is just Charizard versus the Piliswine, and he needs to land this Overheat. If Pirate has Han Shields, that's kind of GG's for Ghost, but we'll see if it lands. And it does land! Ghost able to make the call. Really unfortunate for Pirate Hassan and using that move tech that not many people are running around, the Overheat on the Charizard, able to take the Piliswine out. Really well played from 678 Ghost throughout this tournament. Obviously, there were some really close games, and there was that one game that very well could not have gone, well, could have not gone in his favor if IVs were just that little bit different. But regardless, 678 Ghost is here coming out saying that you don't have to run the exact same team with the exact same moves, even if you may have to run the exact same team. But with that said, thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, especially that subscribe one. Thank you to my 678 Ghost again. He's one of my locals, so really nice to sort of see him battling. Hopefully he doesn't well, maybe I can learn his strategies when we have to play each other in the Newcastle Amber Cup tournament. See you soon, Ghost. But yeah, thank you to my patrons and supporters on YouTube as well, and yeah, I'll see you in the next video, whatever that may be. And you can check out the other recap I did of my second place finish in an Amber Cup tournament as well. It's on the channel, you know, subscribe and all that. Bye.